Let's continue the comfy UI playlist. Previously, I tried using multiple LoRAs. Now we will be looking at InPainting, and this will be a simple video for beginners. I will be using the stable diffusion 1.5 and SDXL models. In the next video, I will cover the Flux model, which will be a bit more advanced. I have the basic workflow here. And for InPainting, I need to introduce an image on which the AI will work according to our prompt. In the current workflow, I am providing an empty latent image, a canvas of size 512 pixels on which the image was generated using the stable diffusion 1.5 model. For InPainting, I will be modifying this canvas. First, I will search for the set latent node. This node will take the mask for InPainting and send it to the K-sampler in latent form. I hope you remember that in the previous video, I mentioned that the AI works in latent space. Therefore, I need the VAE encode node to encode the pixel image and send it along with the latent mask to the K-sampler. Finally, I will add the load image node, which brings the image into the workflow. I will upload the image here, and the pixel image will be converted into latent space. Then, with a mask, it will go to the K-sampler. I removed the set latent node and connected the empty latent node to obtain a subject for this video. I took a prompt from Civet AI and tried generating a subject. I will use this image. I can copy the image and paste it into the load image node. Empty latent is not required now. I will connect the image and mask latent to the K-sampler. Next, I will right-click on the image and open the mask editor. With the brush selected, I will decrease the thickness and create a mask for this image. If you do not understand what a mask is, think of it as a layer on top of an image. I will paint the area on that layer where the AI will work when I process this workflow. For this example, I will try to change the eyes. So I will save the mask. Next, I will describe the changes in the prompt. My prompt will be beautiful brown eyes. Below, these many negative words are not necessary right now. I will run the workflow. Because I am using the stable diffusion 1.5 model, the result may not be perfect. The result I obtained is not good. This is common, and you may need to try a few more attempts. You can also experiment with changing the prompt or increasing the weight of the word to emphasize. Select the word and press Ctrl plus up. By default, the weight is 1, and now it has been increased by 0.1. You can also decrease the weight by pressing Ctrl plus down. This result looks fine. I can upload this image to the load image node and start working on it further. To see the difference side by side, you can simply pull a connection from the image node and use a preview image node. This will display the output generated by the load image node. The difference is not noticeable. I think I achieved the best possible eyes when I decided to copy and work further. Next, I will try to change the color of her hair. I will open the mask editor again, clear the previous selection, and paint the hair area to create a mask. I will save the mask and write a prompt to change the hair color. I tried purple hair, and this is the result I obtained. I did not achieve this result on the first attempt. This is my 11th attempt. Here are some of the failed images. When you are in painting, do not expect a perfect result on the first try. You need to experiment with settings and prompts. After a few attempts, you should get a result that is close to what you expect. I downloaded this LoRA for colorful hair. I don't think it is intended for realistic hair, but let's see what kind of result it produces. I made some space and searched for the load LoRA node, then connected it to the clip text encoders and subsequently to the model with the K-sampler. I selected the LoRA and set the LoRA weight to around 70%. I can use these trigger words as a prompt. LoRA and prompt are added. I will cue the workflow. The LoRA created a background window. After 12 attempts, I obtained this image. The hair color looks good on her. The Laura was also creating a background in the image, so the mask now includes both the hair and the background. I achieved a decent result with some background included. The stable diffusion 1.5 and XL models are still used by many because, unlike Flux, they are uncensored and can be used to create various types of content. Now let's look at the SDXL model. I will be using the Juggernaut XL model. I will start with a default workflow, and below are the nodes for InPaint. You will see the difference between both models. I will be using the same prompt and queuing the workflow. I forgot to select the SDXL model. So this is the result I get with the SD 1.5 model. I do not need this in the prompt, so I will remove it and then run the workflow. The image I obtain is completely different. Now I can also show you in painting on this image. But what if you want the same image we used before? The previous image was a 512-pixel image, which is suitable for SD 1.5 models. For SDXL, the image size should be around 1024 pixels. I retrieved the image from comfyUI's output folder. Now I have to increase the size. I can use an upscaling node in between, but I don't want the image to be upscaled every time I run the workflow. I took the upscale image node and made a connection with a load image node. Then I pulled a connection for the save image node. I will increase the size to 1024 pixels and select the upscaling method. The default method works fine, but you can try others as well. After that, I will run the node, and now I have an image with a size of 1024 pixels. Next, I will copy and paste the new image to the load image node for InPainting. I will create a mask in the mask editor by quickly painting the hair. My prompt is for purple hair. You will see a difference in the result when compared to the stable diffusion 1.5 models. I got the result, and it was quick. There are some colors on her forehead from the original image, but that can be fixed. I will process the workflow again. And this result looks good. There are some defects around her shoulder, but those are not very frequent, so I will try again. The orange markings are again remnants from the original image. I can fix that by using InPainting. I do not want to lose the mask I created, so I will duplicate the load image node. I will copy the result and use it for InPainting, decreasing the brush thickness and opacity. I will save the mask. I also need the words used to describe her skin in the original prompt. It was warm, light skin. I will use the same description in the prompt. I will connect the nodes in the workflow and queue the workflow for processing. The opacity here was too low, which failed to clear the mark. I will paint it again, and it should work. Now it is perfect. The mask editor is simple. And most of the time, I only adjust the brush thickness. You can change the mask color visible to us. The color options are black, white, and negative. You can disable the mask using this checkbox. This will set the entire mask's opacity. Disable the image layer with this. Smooth precision. I have never used this. It makes the brush lighter. The hardness and softness of the brush, which I always have at default. This gives you a square brush. This can be useful in some cases, but I have never used it. The eraser does not need an explanation, and this bucket will pour the paint on the entire image, which I never used. This pen makes a mask, but still I did not have a use case. I made a mask for the area below her neck and tried adding a wearable. When I obtained a decent quality image, I created an image-to-image workflow to generate an identical image without any defects. The image is given to the K-sampler to produce a similar image. All I have is the denoising value, which controls the level of freedom the AI has while generating an image. A denoising value of 0.40 changed the character's face. decreasing it to 0.30, produced an image similar to the original. I did not provide a prompt, which I should have, but this is how I obtained an improved image. There are other ways to achieve better results, which I will demonstrate in future videos. In the next video, let's explore an advanced workflow for InPainting that yields even better results.